don't have any religions, or I'm agnostic because I was before Muslim.
Wow.
Yeah, I've been Muslim like for a long time. But like the thing that made me leave my religion is that there is a lot of humiliating principles in Islam.
Mm.
As a woman, I can't believe in these things.
Mm.
Honestly, like I'm not trying to be racist or Islamophobia. Actually, but
try to be yourself.
Yeah, I'm just saying, like, no one is in his fully mental health would believe in that, because this is insulting for humanity, honestly. Mm. Like in Quran, in Sunnah, they saying that it's okay to beat women, it's okay to take her freedom and all these things. Like this what I believe. This what I believe. Actually, that's why I don't believe.
But you know the Muslim, you know, because I actually reach out to Muslim because we love people. They deny this. They say, oh, women get a lot of rights, and many Western women
actually,
even become Muslims.
They don't want to admit that there's a lot of wrong things in Islam.
Uh-huh.
But if you read the real Sunnah, and if you open the Quran, the real Quran, you're gonna see all of this written there.
Mm-hmm.
It's like it's Islam.
Oh.
I'm sorry, but I'm gonna say what I believe in. The people who apply Islam, like the real Islam, it's ISIS.
Sahabat official, jadi seperti itulah taktik dari para misionaris barat dalam rangka meredam atau menekan perkembangan umat Islam yang begitu pesat di negara mereka, khususnya di Amerika dan Eropa sana. Mereka menciptakan sebuah propaganda kebohongan-kebohongan yang ternyata kebohongan-kebohongan mereka sudah terbongkar sejak lama, sehingga agama Kristen ini justru banyak ditinggalkan di negara-negara Eropa dan Amerika sana. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, sahabat official. Senang rasanya kita bisa berjumpa lagi melalui channel ini ya, dengan ilmu agama yang berbeda-beda, tentunya agar kita mengerti di mana letak kebenaran yang disembunyikan Allah di balik perbedaan keyakinan beragama. Semoga ada hikmah dan ibroh yang bisa kita ambil, kita petik dari video-video ini ya, sahabat official.
The people who apply Islam, like the real Islam, it's ISIS. These crazy people are applying it, like
to the because Muhammad, he had sex slaves, he promoted.
And he had like 11 wives.
Yeah, and also it says in the Quran that, you know, I think it's a Quran that, you know, you can possess sex slaves in your right hand,
exactly.
So you can have unlimited sex slaves. And some Muslim scholars, they don't even deny this.
Yeah.
Some,
because
you know,
they don't want to admit the bad things in the religion. That's what I think.
No.
They don't want to admit that their religion is completely crazy, honestly. I was Muslim since like 18 years of my life. Since I born, I am Muslim, and I lived Islam. Once I got like an adult, I lived that. Because
this is why, you know, God is interested in letting us know that Jesus Christ came to give us freedom. Because the enemy came to deceive us, why Jesus came to give us freedom. And they want to do everything possible to stop the truth from people.
Sahabat official, ternyata inilah rekaman para misionaris Kristen untuk meliput seorang murtadin yang sengaja direkam untuk menjatuhkan citra Islam. Islam dikatakan seperti ISIS. Islam dikatakan merendahkan derajat wanita. Intinya segala ucapan dan tindakan mereka memang bertujuan untuk menghambat perkembangan Islam yang mulai mengambil alih kota mereka. Sehingga mereka membuat kebohongan-kebohongan terhadap Islam, khususnya membahas perihal perempuan yang menjadi senjata mereka. Contohnya seperti video berikut ini.
These are the 10 top hadith on women by the Prophet Muhammad. Let's start with number 1. A woman is like a rib. Beautiful. I love ribs. Number 2. A woman should not set out on a 3 days journey without a male guardian. Because why would you even get out of your house? Stay inside. Number 3. Woman disrupts the prayer exactly like a monkey. The best thing you can do is to disappear when people are praying. They should not see you or hear you. Okay, sister? Number four, a married woman is not permitted to dispose anything of her wealth. If her husband is responsible for her, I mean, yeah, it's your money, but why would you need it? You do have a husband. Number five, a woman using her husband's money to do anything good, like a donation, will only get half a reward. I mean, everything about you is half. Number six, a woman cuts off the prayer exactly like dogs. I love dogs though. Number seven, a woman is not allowed to shave her head. It's your hair, however, you have to keep it long to prove that you are a woman. The longer, the better. Number eight is extremely important because the Prophet wanted to tell women that they have to prostrate themselves for their husbands. I mean, after God, it should be a man that you worship. Keep worshiping, okay? Number nine, a woman cannot be in charge of her marriage, meaning that she cannot make a decision about her marriage. Only a guardian, a male guardian, because you're a woman, you don't know better. You cannot make decisions about your life, especially not marriage. So a man will be taking care of that. Number 10, if your husband died, you should stay within the same town or same city as your family. You are not allowed to go to another city and start a new life. Far away from them. They need to see what you are doing. And these two last hadiths are just a bonus. Number 11, a woman is just like a horse and a house in terms of bad luck. Oh yeah, this hadith says it clearly. And listen to number 12. A woman cannot fast, not Ramadan, just fasting, without the permission of her husband, even in relationship with your God. Permission. You should get the approval of your husband. This is basically how the Prophet Muhammad saw women, described them, how he want other people to treat them. This is the respect and the unique position of women in Islam. There are many hadiths that are fucked up that I didn't mention today, but I can make videos about them in the future. However, I think these hadiths are enough for today.
Nah, sahabat official, jadi inilah contoh murtadin yang tidak mengerti tentang ajaran Islam, khususnya tentang hadis-hadis Nabi. Dia hanya mengambil sisi buruknya saja, menafsirkan seenaknya, lalu mereka ungkapkan ke media sosial. Nah, sahabat official, sementara catatan yang baik dalam pembentukan moral serta ketaatan untuk kebaikan diri sendiri, khususnya bagi wanita tersebut, mereka sembunyikan. Rupanya sifat para murtadin itu sama saja di dalam negeri maupun di luar negeri. Mereka sibuk menjelek-jelekkan Islam dan memberi stigma-stigma negatif terhadap Islam.
Allahumma inni as'aluka bi anni ashhadu annaka antallah la ilaha illa anta antal ahadus samad lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad.